Good. Very good. Thank you, Dan. Good morning. Is this on yet? Hello? It is. Okay, very good. Good morning, everyone. The fog and smoke have cleared, revealing a beautiful day for a graduation ceremony. And thank you for maneuvering and manipulating all of the construction to get here. A good reminder of all the all-nighters that some of you have maybe engaged to finish your degrees, and the all-nighters some of us are working on to get ready for the new semester. And this is fitting because graduations are both endings and beginnings. And so with that, today, my dear students, dear graduates, you become our colleagues. Welcome. Please have a seat, everyone. Thank you. My name is Brett Weber. I have the honor of being the chair of the social work department. More importantly, I have the honor of being a social work educator. And most importantly, I have the honor of being a social worker. Welcome, graduates, colleagues, and friends and family, both those of us who are here in person and those of us joining online. Hello. There have been many tears, tears of joy, tears of challenge, sleepless nights, but maybe now you'll get some rest because their work is done. It's graduation day. Graduates, the hard work, maybe not today, but the hard work is about to begin. The University of North Dakota first offered its first social work class in 1905 during the Progressive Era, the same period when the state was building the only state-owned mill in the country, still the largest building in town. It was the same period when North Dakota founded the nation's only state-owned bank. Many good things came from that period. UND first offered MSW degrees in the 1980s. We continue as the only MSW program between Minneapolis and Spokane, Washington, across the Upper Plains. Today, about a quarter of UND graduates are graduate students, and social work is the third largest program at the university. The University of North Dakota is proud of its social work program and the extensive service to our state and region provided by our graduates. Dear colleagues, this is our first in-person graduation program in almost 2 years. It's so good to see you in person. Thanks for being here, either live in person or online. And it's worth noting, UND has always been a leader in online education, going back to the very beginning. Facing the challenges of our geography, we were one of the first, and we continue to be one of the most important online programs in social work education. So again, a special welcome to our online grads and guests. This is also the first time that we've had a combined pinning and hooding ceremony. The pinning ceremony is for our undergraduates in honor of a beloved social work professor, Myrna Haga. And the hooding ceremony is this funny cape that we get to wear, designating the distinction of a graduate degree. Graduates, hi. You succeeded and accomplished both addressing the regular challenges of earning a university degree and doing so through a worldwide pandemic. The world changed since your first social work class. Now that's always true, but it's been particularly dramatic in this case. Indulge me a moment with a little joke. I'm a bad joke teller, but indulge me. The social worker says to the individual that they're working with, "I've got some good news and some bad news. The good news is you're all right. The bad news is everything you're seeing is real." That's kind of the world we're in right now, yes? As we adjust to a new normal, a new understanding of the importance of public health, a new understanding of the disparities that exist in our society, have long existed but have been revealed by this pandemic, and a new understanding of the role of technology in our personal and professional lives. please take care of yourselves. Those of us who have had the privilege of air travel know that you have to put on your mask before you help others. You need to be healthy in order to help others. Indeed, the Code of Ethics has recent new guidelines for self-care. It's an important part of being an effective social worker. At the same time, I ask you to find balance and to avoid self-absorption, excessive navel-gazing, and do not use self-care as an excuse to avoid the rigors and demands of your responsibilities. You chose this profession. Maybe in some ways this profession chose you as well, but the reality is you understand that this profession has its challenges, its strengths, its the requirement for a great deal of emotional labor. Most importantly, I'd ask that you avoid the self-fulfilling prophecy of despair. There are problems in the world. And yet, in some ways, the world is better today than it's maybe ever been. We have a deeper understanding. But there are problems that need to be addressed. And as we look at those problems and come to understand those problems, it's easy to get overwhelmed, both by the large existential threats that we all face, but also the day-to-day challenges of burnout and the excessive emotional labor that you'll engage. And if you give into that and start believing that there's nothing but despair, then you become part of the problem. So you have to stay healthy and stay strong so that you can avoid that self-fulfilling prophecy of despair. Fortunately, social work is one of the best, if not the best, positioned professions for addressing these problems and for making the world a better place. Our training, our unique values, perspectives, and our code of ethics provide us with the tools to help. Your families, teachers, and all of us know how special you are. Let's work together to make the world a better place, even if it's just one person, one family, one community, or one policy at a time. We're all so very proud of you. I hope you feel that today. And with that, I'd like to introduce the program's program directors. Stephanie Homestead, our distance education director, Professor Homestead. Dr. Isaac Kakari, our MSW program director. Bruce Reeves, Professor Bruce Reeves, field education director. And at this time, I'd like to hand things over to Professor Kitko, Barbara Kitko, our BSSW program director.
Yeah, I was thinking we should have a band.
There.
Welcome. This is such a wonderful day for us as faculty. It's kind of like our payday to see students shining and entering into the profession after all of your hard work, and we know it's work. And so welcome. I will echo what Dr. Weber said about entering this noble profession. I also like to remind students of what an honor and a privilege it is to walk with people who are allowing us, whether it be individuals, families, communities, on micro, macro, and meso level of practice. And so it is a privilege, and we have to keep that in mind. And sometimes it's not always easy. And so welcome. We look forward to all the wonderful things that you will do as you move forward. So as we enter into the program, we're going to start off with our two, each cohort gets to nominate student speakers, and our campus cohort has decided, we have two students that were willing and able and took on this challenge. So they are going to start the speaking, and Mary Bird and Elena Link, if you will come up And
it's still a little short, but Barb is 5 foot even maybe.
Okay. Good afternoon, friends, family, and fellow graduates. My name is Elena Link, a second degree student here on the on-campus bachelor's program. Having previously earned a degree in forensic science and minors in chemistry, criminal justice, and Spanish, I can comfortably say that there is no program like the social work program here at UND, and I am honored to be with you all today.
And hi, everyone. My name is Mary Bird. I am a secondary degree student as well. I have a psychology degree before this, and I have been accepted into the master's program, which I'll pursue later this month. And I have a consulting business here in Grand Forks and East Grand Forks, and I'll be pursuing that as well. Like Elena, I feel so honored to be here today, but mostly grateful to all of you who have supported us during this last year, especially our faculty.
A few weeks ago, when Professor Kitko reached out and informed us that we had both been nominated by our seminar class to speak, and we were given the option of either being put on a ballot and having to have an election in our class or do a joint presentation. It was a no-brainer for Mary and I, as we are both extremely competitive people, as demonstrated in our HBSE2 debates, and an election would get heated in the seminar class. And it also made sense because we started our program off together in Julie's policy class, so we might as well end the program together as well with a joint speech.
So despite having gone through an entire program with each other and with all of you, Elena and I only met in person for the first time a few weeks ago, and for many of us, it was the first time meeting in person ever today. And it was crazy because Elena wasn't just this floating head, like you had legs and a torso, and it was really nice to meet you. And despite not meeting in person, we've all been able to share in the challenges this year brings, and also share in the resilience of our social work community. Somehow the faces that showed up on my computer screen each morning were a wonderful source of connection, friendship, and hope. At a time when our world is experiencing so much division, it gives me hope that there are so many of us with passion and drive to unite it, to make it a more empowered, safe, and compassionate place.
Moving forward from our studies here at UND, we will have moments in our profession of great hardship and of great joy, days of heartbreak, and moments that are truly heartwarming. We will know pain and sorrow, but also grace and humility. We will be a voice for those who cannot speak for themselves, advocates for those who are silenced, and scientists for hope. You may be the one who is meant to hear it. You have the power to create change, and it is our responsibility to impact the world for the better. Very few professions allow you to have this privilege to change the hearts, minds, policies, laws, and the world. As you move on to your next adventure, wherever it may bring you, remember Mother Teresa's words and do small things with great love. Bring that love, passion, and hope wherever you go, and you will move mountains.
We want to thank every single one of you for coming to support us today. As social workers, we are often the helpers and the supporters, but today shows that even the helpers and difference makers need encouragement, care, and understanding. To our professors, I know that you do not get paid enough for the work you do. I don't know any social workers that do, but you are sending ripples out into oceans of need. You make a difference. You ignite our passions, you create change and hope for all, and you do this all while grading our grammatically incorrect social policy papers, answering emails begging for extensions, and attending how many meetings that could have easily been an email. Without educators like you, we wouldn't be standing here today, ready to pursue our passions, create change, or take on the world by storm. We owe you so much more than our gratitude, which is why Elena and I will be making that final tuition payment today. Unfortunately, I won't be able to donate very much to the alumni fund because, well, we'll be social workers.
Now, whether you are a second degree student or a first timer, part of the bachelor's program or here because of grad school, survive the semester on campus or through the distance option, we are all here today, together, united by our passion to help others and to celebrate our accomplishments. So let me be the second person to say congratulations, because we freaking did it. And to wrap up this last few crazy semesters, we're going to send you off with a rap that we wrote. So beware here. If you want to hit it, you want to sit down.
Now this is a story all about how our futures got flipped, turned upside down, and we'd like to take a minute, just sit right there, going to tell you how we became graduates and social workers. At UND, we were taught and educated, out in the fields where we grew and were evaluated, following up, advocating, assessing all day, starting our careers to make a difference some way. Studying hard, and now it's time to use some values. Good thing we're led by the NASW. First we survived months of the COVID pandemic. Now all we gotta do is pass that test and use some ethics. Case manage, 960s, push paper 2, evaluate, network coordinating. There's lots to do. Hard work, yes it is, yet love it most days. Which is good, cause this field sure ain't for the pay. Our futures are bright and filled with new things. Careers or grad school, who knows what it brings. But looking at my cohort, we're finally there. Sitting here today, being social workers.
Okay, thank you all for putting up with that. Mary and I will be selling copies of our record in the back after the pinning. Let this be proof that Mary and I should definitely keep our day jobs. Again, we want to say thank you to all of you for your unending support and love. I'd like to end with a quote by the great Theodore Roosevelt that I think is appropriate for this occasion. It is not the critic who counts, not the man who points out how the strong man stumbles, or where the doer of deeds could have done them better. The credit belongs to the man who is actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who strives valiantly, who errs, who comes short again and again, because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, but who actually strives to do the deeds, who knows great enthusiasms, the great devotions, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end of triumph, high achievement, and who at the worst, if fails, at least fails while daring greatly, so that his place shall never be without those cold and timid souls who neither know victory nor defeat. So get back out into that arena and give it all you got. We've got your back. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Mary and Elena. I don't think we've ever had anybody do a video. It's pretty exciting. Okay, so our distance cohort, and we have several of our distance students that are actually here on campus, have nominated us, their speaker, and their speaker is going to come online. His name is Tad Wood.
Hello, everybody. I hope everybody can hear me okay. First of all, I don't have a great speech like the previous speakers did. However, I'll start off. First of all, I want to thank my classmates for nominating me to speak today. I was pretty surprised, actually. And also, my name is Tad. I'm from Duluth, Minnesota. I'm also a second degree student. So like most of my classmates, I'm not a typical age college student. Like my classmates, I have my own family, full-time job, lots of bills. Own a house, probably like most of my other classmates, but we made it. This was extremely tough for myself, and I'm sure a lot of other people in this program who have tried to manage their daily life activities amongst going to school during a pandemic and online. So my academic career started about 10 years ago in 2011. I earned my first bachelor's degree in criminal justice studies and a minor in Spanish from the University of North Dakota in 2016. Immediately after graduating, I began working as a correctional officer. I began growing through the ranks within corrections. And during my career in corrections, I noticed myself being more understanding. And I noticed I was one of the few staff members where the inmates felt comfortable approaching myself and having conversations with. I began acknowledging my bias within the inmate population and realized that they are people. I saw them as people. I saw them as my potential neighbor. I treated them with dignity and worth. I began developing a stronger sense of empathy at this point. At this point in my career, I needed more. I felt like I had a stronger purpose. Throughout this BSSW program, I've met some great people who I call my classmates and friends. Yet I have today to meet them yet, but hopefully in the future I will. However, this program was unique to me because those classmates also represented the same amount of empathy as I did, as well as having similar attributes as myself. I saw the drive and passion in my classmates as I do to serve individuals who are in need. Like I said before, I already have earned a different degree in the past from University of North Dakota within the Criminal Justice Department, but within the short amount of time that I've had within the BSSW program, I believe I've learned so much more, and my instructors and coworkers have provided realistic and in job training scenarios to prepare us for our career. I cannot thank my instructors enough. With that being said, congratulations, class of 2021.
Thanks, Tad. So now we are going to move on to our pinning ceremony. I'm going to ask the faculty to please come up. I would encourage family members who are in the audience, this is an informal opportunity. You can come down, take pictures, move around. This is for you guys. And so if your family members want to come down and take pictures closer up, they certainly can. So I will ask faculty to come and we will walk through the students one by one and their advisor. What we will do is I'll announce the graduate's name, where their field placement was at, their seminar topic, research topic, as well as their advisor and the person who will be pinning them. We do have a number of advisors that are online and not here. So the students that are here, you will have the opportunity to be pinned by somebody else, some of the other faculty. So, all right, we will go ahead and get started. Noelle Ames is our first graduate. She was at High Plains Fair Housing. Her research topic was evictions, moratorium, and Kelly Gast is her advisor. And all right, so welcome, Noelle, thank you. Tanya Barron is our next graduate. Her field placement was Spectre Health. Her research topic was medicated assistant treatment for addiction. Shanna Urban is her advisor, and I get the pleasure of pinning her. Melanie Bosch Pudwell is the next graduate. She's attending online. Her field placement was Three Rivers Human Service Zone. Her research topic was fetal substance abuse. Shanna Urban is her advisor, and Jenny Schlinger online is going to pin her.
Congratulations, Melanie.
Thank you.
This is the first time we've done this too, so. All right, Michaela Brown is our next graduate. Her field placement was Senior Helpers Home of Eastern North Dakota. Her research topic was integrating holistic psychology into social work practice. And Isaac Kakari is her advisor. Mary Bird is our next graduate. She was at Grand Forks Public Schools. Her research topic was trauma-informed care, guiding and serving youth. Kelly Gast is her advisor, but Jennifer Modine is going to pin her. Chelsea Christie is our next advisor. She was her field placement was Eckert Youth Homes. Her research topic was workforce shortage. Shanna Urban is her advisor, but Stephanie Homestead is going to pin her. Tanya Dufanay is our next graduate. Her field placement was Spirit Lake Tribal Social Services. Her research topic was Indian Child Welfare Act. Kelly Gast is her advisor, but I get the honor of pinning her. Darian Jackson is our next graduate. Her field placement was Chandesika Chinkana Community College Head Start. Indigenous mental health was her research topic, and Stephanie Homestead is her advisor. Jamie Clouser is joining us online. Her field placement was Ref Rider North Human Service Center. Her research topic was Native American children in foster care, and Stephanie Homestead is her advisor. All right. Marissa Koch is our next graduate. Her field placement was Range Mental Health Center. Her research topic was mental health practice shortage. Kelly Gast is her advisor, and Jennifer Schlinger is going to be pinning her.
Congratulations, Marissa.
Natalie Listema is our next graduate. Her field placement was Human Development Center. Research topic was the ethical problem of civil commitment, and Angie Muse is her advisor. And I'm not sure. Oh, there she is. She's
virtual. Good. Virtual winning. I love it.
Elena Link was at Fargo Public Schools. Her research topic was social emotional learning, and Isaac Kakari is her advisor. Jordan Minsky, Minsky. See, I had it earlier. Jordan Minsky is our next graduate. She was at Spectra Health. Her field research topic was harm reduction model. Yiping Shea is her advisor, and Stephanie Homestead is going to be pinning her. Zoe Saylor is joining us online. Her field placement was Milestone Youth Home. Her research topic was school to prison pipeline, and I have the honor of pinning her. Congratulations, Zoe. Emily Sheely was at Eventide Heartland Care Center. Her research topic was analyzing the mental and physical health of residents in long-term facilities during the COVID-19 pandemic, and Angie Muse is her advisor. Oh, did I? Well, that's horrible.
We'll get her.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
And I missed a couple. So, wow, how did I do that? I jumped out. Okay, Sandra Novak is our next graduate. She was at Hope Church. Her research topic was Columbia Suicide Assessment, and I have the honor of pinning her. Christopher Ortiz is joining us online. He was placed at Children's Home Society. His research topic was therapeutic anger menu. Craig Burns is his advisor, and Jenny Schlinger is going to be pinning him online.
Congratulations, Christopher.
All right. Our next graduate is Emily Rao. She was at All Embracing Home Care. Her research topic was incarcerated females. Yiping Shea is her advisor, and Angie Muse is going to be pinning her. All right, our next graduate is Kayla Safransky. Her field placement was at Alma, and her research topic was environmental diagnosis. Karen Lee Barkdahl is her advisor, and Stephanie Homestead is going to be pinning her. Okay, so we did Emily. Shannon Schneeweiss is our next graduate. She was at Edgewood Healthcare. Her research topic was Money Follows the Person. Karen Lee Barkdahl was her advisor, and Angie Muse is going to be pinning her. Jennifer Sheehan is our next graduate. She's joining us online. Her field placement site was Benedictine Living Community of Ottawa, and her research topic was reducing antipsychotic medications in long-term facilities. Yiping Shea is her advisor, and Jenny Schlinger is going to be pinning her.
Congratulations, Jennifer.
Last but not least of our undergraduate graduates is Tad Wood. His field placement was Lutheran Social Services of Wisconsin. His research topic was recidivism rates between Minnesota and Wisconsin and aftercare services offered. And I have the honor of pinning you, Tad.
Congratulations.
And that ends the pinning part of this ceremony. We're going to move on to the hoodings. So, do you want us to sit down? Or should we stay? Awesome. All right.
And we are glad to be celebrating with our graduates. And just a quick comment on the mic stand. I think it's a lesson in equity for all social workers. Some of us are short, some are tall. So, yeah. Okay. So for our graduates, even as we share in your story and your journey, we'll go ahead with a hooding. And first we have Morgan Ashton. Her topic is effects of homelessness on families and children. And her advisor is Dr. Yiping Shea, but she'll be hooded by Professor Muse. Yes.
Congratulations.
Yes. Congrats.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Go.
Go.
So next we have Claire Chalupnik, and her topic was Please Reform. I am her advisor and I have the honor of hooding her. So, okay.
Did you get good pictures? Okay, do you want to pose?
You guys should pose.
Listen to me, social work. Big stuff.
The last time anyone's here to get a picture. Thank you. Congratulations.
So next we have Maura Ferguson. Unfortunately, she is not here, but her topic was building active intersectional allyship in middle school youth. And her advisor was Karen Lee Bagdell. So, yes, and we have Courtney. Yes, Courtney is wondering whether she's on. Yes, Courtney, you are here. So Courtney Haviland, and she led alcohol and substance use among juvenile justice involved youth in North Dakota. And she'll be hooded by Professor Reeves. Yes.
All of Vermont. Good? Everybody good? All right. Congratulations.
Hey, way to go. Well done.
And Courtney's advisor was Professor Shade. So just for the record, yeah. Thank you.
Well, there's a larger ceremony over at the Chester Fritz Auditorium this afternoon, and you're certainly welcome and encouraged to attend there. But it's nice for us to have this less formal, more intimate gathering. So thank you for taking the time to join here, and please, let's hang around for a few minutes and say hello to one another, and lots of opportunities for taking photographs. Thank you again for coming out, and congratulations to our graduates.
The graduates come up. We're going to take some group pictures. Families can certainly come up and take pictures of just the graduates. We'll do the undergraduate and then the MSW students.
Thank you so much, Dan. That was awesome.
Hi there, is it on? I just wanted to say a quick thank you to Dan Boise, who has helped with the technology here. He is our rock star.